Good afternoon and welcome. We are on a weekend with the Golden Heart Wisdom team. So good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
And so we thought it'd be a good occasion to just enjoy the outdoors in nature. You may hear some nature sounds. You may hear some wonderful children having fun. And so we thought we love to have these different conversations, topics that we know are really pertinent and coherent for you, and to just address some of those topics. So today is something that's been very present for me, I'll be honest, and that I think I've managed to dissolve a good part of it. I see it, normally we would have heard the kids screaming in the background and thought, oh, we can't do this, it'll never be perfect. Whereas now it's like, hey, it's part of life. So today we're talking about performance, mm-hmm. and needing to be the best at everything, or needing to always outperform ourselves, or set unrealistic objectives, or something we think is realistic, but just always pushing the machine, you know, and always going further. Yeah. You probably have a few things you'd like to say on that topic as well.
Yes. Well, I've been there also, you know, as many of us, as probably all of us. But when I realized that the more I was working hard, the less the results would be there in their highest capacities. When I realized that is after a few times when instead of working hard and making sure that I would achieve a certain goal, when I just watch nature and did the same thing. Nature never work hard. Nature is always at peace. Nature is, and it goes with the flow. So, you know, we never see a tree wanting to perform and to add many leaves. The tree is, right?
Like, and imagine a tree, I gotta be the biggest one here and the greenest one. And
yeah, same with flowers.
Yeah, you'd be like, silly flower, what are you doing? You're a flower.
Yeah. So I said, nature is so smart. So why wouldn't I look at what nature does and do the same? And I started to experience it. And at first, you know, it's very minus. There's not a lot of results that were happening. But at some points, I started to see something different. And not only what I could see that was concretely manifested, but the way that I was feeling, much more clear, much more fluid and light. And life would become fun instead of like a puzzle. And, you know, when I go to sleep at night, I still have energy instead of being completely exhausted at 2 p.m., you know?
It's really counterintuitive, though, when you think about it, to say, okay, I'm going to slow down, I'm going to relax, but I'm going to perform better. No, wait a minute. There's something I think you may not have understood, right?
Right.
We grow up with the thinking, you know, you got to work hard to play hard. It's always, you know, push more. And the harder you work, the longer the hours you work, you know, the whole concept of working as many hours as possible, that's the only way we'll make more money, right?
Yes.
And that's the only way we'll be able to live that ultimate lifestyle.
Yes.
Is if we're working hard.
Yes.
Whereas, and I've experienced it as well, when you're really connected and just kind of going with the flow, you're not sitting there going like, well, you know, if nothing's happening, it's more of taking inspired actions. You receive inspirations, you follow up on them, but you're not rowing upstream, working hard, trying to make and force things to happen.
Yes.
Sometimes we know.
Yeah.
We're like, why is this so hard, you know?
Yeah. It's not supposed to be that hard, right? But in the meantime, this is how we get acknowledged by society.
Yeah.
You know, how often do we meet someone that we didn't see for a long time and asking, how are you doing? And the first thing that they will share is how many hours they're working.
Yeah, or I've got this job, or, you know.
Yes, and the
effort.
Their
success,
Yes, they'll talk about the effort. And it's beautiful, but it can be easier. And while it gets easier, we get access and we tap into the resources that are there for us. But they are available. But because we're working so hard, they became inaccessible at some point, at some point, instead of being there and presenting themselves as we are taking inspired actions, as you shared. So it's not about, you know, just meditating and taking pauses, but pauses are so important. Even a few minutes, You know, when every hour or 2 hours, if we take like 2, 3, 5 minute breaks and just breathe deeply, it creates more space and room for accessing and harmonizing the heart and the mind that will work together instead of being only in the head and in the mind, trying to control everything that we would love to achieve, instead of allowing all the opportunities to come our way. It's a huge difference.
And I think that sometimes we're working so hard to, you know, we've got this ideal image in our head of what success looks like and how to get yes. there. And we don't even realize that while we're focusing on that one door, there's all this entire buffet of other doors
yes.
that could be possible, but we're actually blocking ourselves from them. We're kind of closing ourselves off from them.
Yes.
And I think you've talked about it before, where the silence between the thoughts, right? And that's what you were just describing, is to take yes. that moment and try it. I really invite you to just give it a try for fun and just say, huh, I don't believe it, but let me give it a shot. And to just, you know, throughout the day, every hour,
yeah.
take a moment to just stop and breathe for what, 1-2 minutes?
Well, a few minutes.
Yeah.
But you talked about the silence between thoughts. But before we can go there, let's say that we take a pause, so we access silence between our activities in our schedule. So after each call, or after an appointment, or after we met with a client or someone, or something happened in our schedule, if we take a few minutes just to breathe and align ourselves to be ready for the next one, we will still be fluid and we will be more open to allow the resources to come our way, and the opportunities and the inspirations. And they can be, you know, material resources, human resources, financial resources as well. But when we are focused on only one degree, because we absolutely want to achieve this goal before we will be happy or before we will feel like we are a success, what we are doing, as you just shared, is instead of allowing the 360 degrees of resources to come all around us, we are narrowing to only one degree. And so we were taught to focus on something. And what I would love to share with you and to invite you to do, to experiment what it feels like to be in the quality of presence instead of focusing. It will allow you to perform, but not because you want to perform, but the performance would be like a byproduct of your quality of presence, the byproduct of the silence between activities, between the words that you are sharing, so you can listen to the other ones as well. And after, between the thoughts, the silence between the thoughts will come with practice. So it's like mastery, instead of being always like the hamster in the hamster wheel.
Yeah. Yes. Running, just constantly go, and you don't even realize. You get to somewhere, oh, I'm sorry, and you don't even realize the energy that you bring into that, say, that meeting or that room, where everyone around is like, geez, what is she on? You know, why is she so hyper?
Yeah.
You get to a point where you don't even realize that that's the impact you're having on everyone else around you.
Yes.
So to just really relax, as we like to joke, you know, my hamster was one buff hamster, but to just give him a break. Let him sip a little bit of lemonade in his hammock and enjoy the beautiful weather.
Exactly. Or you will arrive in a room and everyone in this hyperactivity that they absolutely need to function, to think that they will perform. And when you are getting a little slower because you are breathing, you are allowing everyone to get access to something that is much more powerful than when we are only in the mind. You know, with the new studies that we have now, we know that the heart is 5,000 more powerful in the electromagnetic field than the brain. So, you know, when we focus on the brain, we get exhausted, and we can reach a certain limit, of course, but we can never dive into all the power and all the infinite resources that comes from the heart when we connect to the intelligence of the heart and the wisdom of the heart.
Yeah. And we talk about inspired actions, and sometimes people are like, I don't know what you know, what motivated me to just do that. But that ended up causing this, and it's just,
yes,
it's pretty crazy. Sometimes you think, oh, it's synchronicity, or it's luck, or it's karma, or there's so many different terms. But realistically, that's what an inspired action looks like, is just kind of receiving it, taking the action without expectations of results.
Yeah.
And it's just doing it and seeing, hey, we'll see what comes of this.
And without necessarily having the big picture.
Mm-hmm. That's the hardest.
Yeah.
That's the hardest. It really is.
Yes.
It's like you want to know where you're going. You want to have that big picture. Imagine what it can look like.
Yes.
And so trusting that the universe knows way better what's best for us than what we can imagine. And I remember a while ago, I had applied for a job, and I was, mm-hmm. I really wanted this job, and I cried when I didn't get it. But the fact that I didn't get it caused me to get another job, which made me meet someone who ended up connecting me to you.
Yeah.
Imagine if I had gotten that other job. I may not even be here today. So it's really trusting those inspired actions and trusting that, hey, I don't need to know what the result's going to look like.
Yes.
You let yourself be surprised by life.
Yes. And when we talk about the universe, much of the time we will think as the universe being something separate mm-hmm. from who we are. From the mind, yes, definitely, but not from the heart. So we are co-creators. And when we are listening to the voice of the heart and we receive an inspiration that we really feel with the heart, and we make this first step. So this first inspired action, it will lead us to something else and something else. And at some point we will get the big picture, but not at first. And you know, it can be scary at first, we know that. So that's why the more that you will have your pause and you will breathe a little bit deeper and slower than usual and go to the belly when you breathe, it will assist you. Because what we are telling you right now is not something that you don't know. You already all know what about we're talking about. Maybe you forgot mentally, but from your heart, it will resonate and it will make sense. And it's only for you to practice a little bit, to be comfortable during this period that can be really uncomfortable. We know that, but
I promise it can be very uncomfortable.
Yes, but when we practice and we start to see what kinds of results and manifestations that we are making concrete in our life, and it has an impact on our loved ones and the family and even the colleagues, and even when we are an entrepreneur, it can be with the business mm-hmm. as well. So it is the ultimate lifestyle, not because we want to achieve goals, because when we want to achieve goals, we are focused, as I said, only on the goal, and we're not really living and appreciating it and experiencing, you know, the journey.
Yeah,
it's planning, only the destination.
We're planning, we're strategizing.
Yes.
And if I go back, you know, even just a few years ago, my business was so riddled with effort, and I was exhausted, and I was always, you know, going, and I got to push harder, and I got to make sure this client is happy. Whereas now I'm so much more in the fluidity of things, that it's a lot easier, and things just flow so much more naturally, and I have so much more fun, and I'm not as tired. I think back to how it was before, and I think, oh God, that was exhausting.
Yes. And
it was heavy.
You're making more money.
Yes.
Now.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know,
yeah.
So when we are focused only on we need to make money to be a success, well, we will work hard and we will struggle at
yeah.
some point.
Yeah.
And when we really connect back and be inspired by who you really are, you will be there. The success will be there, but not because you will have worked hard,
mm-hmm.
but just because of who you are.
A byproduct instead of a goal.
Yes. Yep.
So as always, you know, we'd love to have your feedback, your own experiences. Don't hesitate to share them. We just love to, you know, learn and hear what you guys are living and experiencing. And we'll see you guys soon for another one of these fun conversations. Thank you, Sylvie, once again.
Thank you, Sandy.